John Anderson from the Livingston County News, and another update here on this manhunt as it continues. I have Tanner Jubenville with me. You're obviously a reporter for Channel 13 WHAM, and you've been here since the beginning. Everyone's been following you on Twitter. Yeah, usually that's fun for reporters, but this has not been fun. This has been kind of scary situation, but you were here while it was light out. Can you kind of explain what was here, Tanner, when you first got here to compare to now?
Yeah, I mean, we actually were in the area and saw the police officers responding to the scene, and then we saw what was going on, so we turned around, came right back, and got here pretty early on, well before the SWAT team was here, well before the state police helicopters were here. It was kind of a frantic scene, really, just trying to keep our distance, you know, finding out what was going on from state police, and yeah, just a lot going on, a lot of chaos.
Again, Tanner was quick on the scene here with WHAM and really working hard. You guys got to give you guys credit for being here. They've been out in the cold. They've been doing their live shots, doing a great job letting the public know what's happening because it's a scary situation. Sheriff Dougherty came and briefed you. Again, you were one of the first ones here. The sheriff seemed concerned. What was he saying to you?
Well, part of the concern is they didn't know exactly, not only they don't know who this suspect is, they also didn't know where exactly the suspect is. I tried to ask him if they at least think they have a perimeter around him. He said he didn't feel comfortable confirming that at all. So part of the challenge is also tonight, the terrain, he said, has been very tough to deal with, and really just not knowing who this guy is and who the woman is that was in the car with him.
Yeah, crazy. I covered the Bucky Phillips situation. I've covered the David Sweat thing. And the things that you're saying are all familiar, and there's homes around the area. But this one also involves gunfire. And that's what kind of brings us to the next level. You did try to ask him a little bit about the gunfire. What do we know about the gunfire with the Geneseo police?
Well, talking to state police, or there was a state police trooper up on the scene earlier. I talked to him. He said an officer was shot at, but the sheriff later on saying that just shots were fired, not saying who exactly fired the shots, but I mean, it sounds, you know, like that suspect in that vehicle definitely at least pulled a gun on that officer. Obviously, at this point, still not confirmed by the sheriff if that suspect ever fired the shots, but, you know, do know shots were fired, so they're definitely a very serious situation, and they are considering the guy armed and dangerous, so obviously for the people in the area, that's scary too.
All right, Tanner. Well, I know you got to get back and get live. We appreciate you.
So,
all right. Thank you very much. So we're going to continue here, and I'll give you a little bit more of an update of what we heard. So, again, I'm on the scene here with Chris Metcalf, also from the Livingston County News. There's a few things that the Livingston County News does know. Number one, we have heard that the man who's wanted has a history of prison time, over 12 years in prison. Now, again, if you're just joining us or wondering what was happening, around 5:47 p.m. or so, Geneseo police pulled him over, and the woman is in custody. He ran. There's an exchange of gunfire. White male in his 40s. Sheriff Dougherty, again, said, forget the rumors. He's still out there, okay? Armed and dangerous. This is very important for the residents of Geneseo. I don't know if you can hear this, but we have another helicopter going over the head, and we keep seeing the police, and Route 63 is shut down here. The other important thing that we've possibly know, again, this is a big allegedly, but we heard a single gunshot. Again, I'm with Chris Metcalf from the Livingston County News, and we heard a gunshot. We know hunting. We know what a gunshot is. We did talk to one police officer who said, yes, they thought they heard one as well. We don't know what that means. That's all. Bottom line is this. The gunshot was not by any police agency here, and there's several of them. You've got the state police, the Geneseo police, Livingston County police. You've got these SWAT teams, these special units. The gunshot that we heard was not from a police agency. It was a single shot. Take that for what it's worth. We don't know. But again, that's what we had heard, and police also said they believe they heard the same thing. And again, the man that they're looking for, they had North Carolina plates, but we believe they may have had identifications from another state. And talking to the woman, they must have ID'd the man they're looking for. And again, he's prison time. So you've got somebody who's, you know, allegedly served over 12 years in prison, has a gun, and exchanged fire with Geneseo police. Very important. I probably should have said this from the onset if you're joining us. Police were not hurt in this exchange of gunfire. You know, we just got done writing about Nick Clark's situation, the trooper from Canisteo who was shot and killed. So obviously the severity, you know, is fresh on our minds. It's fresh on the minds of the police, and they are everywhere. And, you know, over the years, you talk about interagency cooperation. This is seamless. These guys are all working together with one common goal. Now, one unfortunate thing did happen over by Court Street. Somebody called in a false report that they saw him, and I know the police are not happy with this because they don't think this was a Good Samaritan type situation, and they all had to leave the scene and rush over to Court Street to find out what was going on, and it just turned out to be, I mean, a hoax or something. Chris Metcalf and I, again, from the Livingston County News, were over there, and we saw some guys joking around and saying we're going to get him and this and that, and I really hope that wasn't the case, because, you know, a hoax like that is taking away from the manpower and, you know, the safety of the residents of Geneseo as they try to find this man. So that's where we are right now. We will try to continue to update our website and our Facebook page if we hear anything. Sheriff Dougherty, by the way, on Twitter has been very active all night. I've been following him. So if you follow the Livingston County Sheriff on Twitter, he's been giving some very good updates about what he looks like. He's been dispelling rumors, and he's had a very long day too. Sheriff's worked all day. He was in court today. I saw him earlier. So, you know, when you're looking for accurate information, of course, yes, we're telling you check LCN.com, check our Facebook page, you know. But just to tell the residents of Geneseo, you know, we're checking what the sheriff is saying on Twitter. That's very important to us. You know, obviously, he is the sheriff, and he is giving very, very good information now what is happening here at the scene. And again, the helicopters just continue to circle over us here, Route 63 and 20 here in Geneseo. And if you're familiar with this, you know, you got the road this way would be coming in from Batavia and the Main Street, you know, get going through towards Main Street, Geneseo. So we're just outside the village, outside the college. But again, we're in an area where the police have us kind of the media is all in one spot away from the scene. But we are very close to the scene because, as I said, you know, the helicopters are overhead. So again, if you're just joining us, before we wrap up, the man is in his 40s, 5'9", 200 pounds, wearing some dark clothing. He may have had a hat on at one time, considered armed and dangerous. We appreciate a lot of the comments on the our Facebook posts. We've tried to put up a few posts, and people actually, our viewers here have been posting what they saw and some other things in the area. And so, again, we really appreciate that because you're helping the residents stay safe. And a few of you also said that your neighborhoods and areas were in lockdown. So, you know, be vigilant, be careful out there, you know, or in there in your homes. Because, I was just talking to Chris Metcalf about the David Sweat situation. They were breaking into hunting camps, and that's how they were staying on the run. Bucky Phillips, you know, same thing. So, you know, if this man is not giving up without a fight, then, you know, he'll try to get a vehicle. He'll try to get into a home. We don't know. So, again, we don't know what's happening. All we know is one woman is in custody, and he's out there. So, John Anderson from the Livingston County News, along with Chris Metcalf here, who's been assisting me tonight from Geneseo. And, again, we'll keep you updated. As I'll try to show you just the police here as we sign off.